Artist John from WhatUp, and welcome back to another video. Now, in this video, we're going to do something just a little bit different. We're taking every single set picture that we've seen so far from the production, or leaks, or rumors, or other things like that, and we're putting them all into one video. Now, here's the kicker. I probably have missed at least one or two of these, so if I have, let me know in the comments down below which ones I've missed, which ones were your favorite, etc., etc. Now, also, before we get started, I do want to mention that I'm almost at 5,000 subscribers. I'm very, very close. So here's the deal. I'm going to start this contest with this video. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do so, because you have to be a subscriber, you have to like some of my videos, you have to comment some of the videos for the next, let's say the next 3 weeks. And at the end of the 3 weeks, I will pick a winner. Now, what do you get to win? Well, you get to win one of two different prizes. The first prize will be a Wheel of Time mug, and that mug will have the WhatUp logo on it. I mean, the Dusty Wheel has them, Talk Around Reoid, and Weekly Wheel News, so why can't I, right? Now, the second prize that you could choose from, and this was the main prize that I started with, but then I got some feedback saying that maybe not everyone would like this, is a chance to be in a video with me. So basically, you pick a Wheel of Time topic, we'll Zoom call in, I'll record the whole thing, we'll talk about whatever you like Wheel of Time related, I'll make a video of it and post it so you become, pseudo-YouTube famous, kind of like me. So it's one of those two prizes. All right. With all that out of the way, spoiler warning, in this video, I'm going to be showing you set pictures. Now, these set pictures are from the Wheel of Time production that was most recently filming in the Czech Republic and Spain and Slovenia. So, if you don't want anything for the show ruined, be forewarned, I'm going to ruin a bit for you today, so don't watch the video. Also, if you haven't read at least The Eye of the World, be forewarned, some of these pictures may ruin parts of the story for you. Alright, with all that out of the way, let's get on to the video. Now, in this first section of pictures, we have pictures from Slovenia. These were from October 16th, 2019. So that's, a year and a couple months ago before basically everything happened to the world. So, these pictures, we didn't really know what they were at the time. However, most recently, WattSeries.com talked to a trusted source close to the production that gave some insight into what these pictures could be. Now, these pictures, allegedly, and I'm saying this, take it with a grain of salt, because, it is not official from Amazon, although this is about, as trusted and official as you can get, because WattSeries is batting 1,000. They have not been wrong about anything so far, and their sources are pretty much airtight. So there's that. Now, these pictures seem to depict a new scene that Rafe Judkins, the showrunner, and the rest of the production team have added into season one that is not in the books. Now, this is Egwene's induction into the women's circle. Now, I know she's not part of the women's circle. She's barely a woman in the book. She just learns to braid her hair before, they leave Emmon's Field in the first place. However, this, source said that this is what this depicts. Now, it also involves some caves, a river, a bridge, perhaps Egwene jumping off the bridge or the caves into the river. We're not entirely sure, but that's what they told WattSeries.com. In these pictures, you see a lot of people in safety gear. There's a fair number of people on set in Slovenia. They did an article about it at the time in a local newspaper. And you also get to see a stunt person here wearing a white robe, or a white dress, rather, and what appears to be a black wig with a very large braid, which, it's probably Egwene's stunt double. That's my take on that. So let me know what you think of these pictures down below in the comments. Is this, Egwene's induction into the women's circle? Could it be something different? Is it the first time she uses the power, perhaps? First time that Nynaeve uses the power? Is it a flashback? Could it be anything other than what this source is telling WattSeries.com? I'm not entirely sure, but like I said, the source is pretty airtight, so I'm going to go with what they said. Also, before we get on to the next batch of set pictures, the link to that article is down below in the description box, so go check that out. And if you haven't already bookmarked WattSeries.com, do that. They give you all kinds of really great Wheel of Time news. All right, let's get on to these next set of set pictures that we have for you. All right, up next we have Faldera. Now again, these aren't official pictures. They are behind the scenes and leaks, and a photographer did take them on set when he was there and posted them to his public Facebook, and everyone got a hold of them, and they're all over the net, so if you need them, they're there. But we believe that they show Faldera and parts of the Blight. Now, we're not 100% sure, but, we do see that the Lord of Faldera's standard is there, so it's almost a shoe-in. We get to see a little bit of everything with these pictures. We get to see parts of the keep in Faldera, which is really amazing, with the bridge going across there. We get to see Rand on set in costume. We get to see Egwene on set with him. We get to see him firing some arrows in the background of one of the pictures. We get to see his Heronmark blade. Now, this was before they did the reveal of the Heronmark blade, so this is the first time that we did get to see that. Now, we also get to see what appears to be some Shannaran soldiers on horseback. prepared for battle, whether they're riding into the Blight to go with Moraine and the party to the Eye of the World, or they're heading to Tarwin's Gap. We're not entirely sure. But all of these pictures seem to show a number of different really cool things in and around the Keep in Faldara. And then we get on to near the end of these pictures, we see the Roots Shoots. That's what WattSeries.com affectionately called them. Now, the Roots Shoots were these big, massive, gnarled roots that were pretty much everywhere, and they did some shoots there at night, and it would appear to be some columns and stuff nearby, and there seemed to be some people near the columns. So we speculated that this could be the entrance to the Eye of the World in the Blight, but we're not entirely sure. But these were some really cool pictures, and they were the real first almost HD pictures that we got to see of people on set in costume actually acting, and it was really phenomenal and really neat to see. Now, these are the Faldara pictures, we believe. All right, let's get on to the next batch of pictures that I have for you. All right, up next we have some location pictures for you. Now, these are locations that were shot, some behind-the-scenes pictures, some pictures released by the cast and crew, some pictures that Narg from the Daily Trollog happened to leak to us, and they show a little bit of everything. So we have a Tinker that we just seen there. We have pictures of what we think to be Young Swan's fishing hut, before and after it burned. We also get to see a bunch of pictures of Emmons Field with the mist from the mountains of mist all around it, looking really, really neat there. And we get to see some other images of, you know, towns and you know, probably mostly Emmons Field. I'm going to be quite honest with you. These pictures are probably that. And the last couple of pictures we get to see here are of the Terran. So this is Terran Ferry. Now, this was a picture that Brandon Sanderson sent out in a newsletter, as well as we get to see the Wine Spring Inn. Now, the Wine Spring Inn here up close, we didn't know that this was the Wine Spring Inn at the time. It wasn't until they released the official pictures of Emmons Field and we got to see them later on. But this is the Wine Spring Inn. And now I know people complain there's not enough chimneys, there's not enough of this, there's not enough of that. But guess what? It is really cool we get to see these things up front, up close. And I am geeking out over all these pictures again. I mean, I've seen these all a dozen times and I did videos on them already. But it is still very neat to see all of this stuff firsthand again here in this video. So these are pretty cool. All right, let's get on to the next set of set pictures that we have for you. All right, so these pictures are from Spain. Now, they did a shoot in Spain on the 1st of December, December 1st and 3rd, I want to say. Maybe the 3rd and 4th. Correct me in the comments down below. It was in December anyway. November 30th, they scouted the location, they were there, and then they started filming in December. Only for a couple of days in Spain. Now, this was after they had already shut down production in the Czech Republic, packed up and gone home, and then they started filming in Spain for a couple of days. Now, it was kind of leaked when we did my video that I did on those actors and actresses that were there in Spain, that this is most likely Geldon, and the King of Geldon is there. Loghain was on set, Alvaro Morte. So it was probably some images or, you know, flashback scenes or even some scenes of when he confronted the king, came out as, proclaimed himself as a false dragon or the dragon, I guess, at the time, and then, fought his way out of the kingdom, was stripped of his lands and titles because, you know, remember that Loghain was a noble, so he actually was a noble before he proclaimed himself the Dragon Reborn. That's what we think the scene is from. Now we get to see pictures of the castle here, get to see some pictures of where they're filming, and it was really neat to see. And we did get to see the flags up on the castle. That's the flag of Geldon, so that's how we know that that's Geldon. Plus, Miguel, one of the actors that was in these shoots on his CV, said he was King Arthur, King of Geldon. I'm pretty sure he's probably not Arthur. It was probably a code name, but I mean, they left King of Geldon in there, so probably shoots in Geldon. Anyway, really neat to see. I'm glad to see that they're fleshing out Loghain's storyline just a bit, because he's a really, really important character, in my opinion, for the books, and he really didn't get the justice he deserved. There could have been a whole other book or two about how he handled the Black Tower and what went on there, but it just didn't happen, and I'd hope to see some more of him on screen, which we know Rafe Judkins has already told us that's going to happen, so there's that. All right, let's get on to the next set of set pictures that I have for you. All right, these ones are the Waygate pictures. These ones were taken by a family on vacation, or a staycation, so to speak, during the pandemic, and they stumbled upon the set, really, and they took a bunch of pictures, and they posted them up on their their social media, because that's what families do when you go on vacation. I do it all the time with my kids, my wife, and that's what we do, of course, although I've never found a Waygate just out and about. Now, it was speculated at the time this could have been a portal stone, but that's pretty much been debated to death. It's a Waygate. You can see that the two big columns on either side. In between them, there was a big tarp in one of the pictures that I don't have here for you that had a big green screen in it. So you know that they're probably green screening in all the leaves and the doors and the silveriness of the waygate when they go through it. Now, there was some discussion at the time, why is this waygate out and about in the middle of a field when really the only waygates we see in the first book are in Camelin and in a field in Shinar. So could this have been the waygate in Shinar when they all come out of the waygate and they all, you know, go down the steps of their horses and stuff? It's quite possible that that's the one, or could also be a proxy for the one in Camelin, because, you know, the one in Camelin is in the basement of a structure, and that's not really going to be cool to have a bunch of horses go down in a basement and try to put them through a door. It won't look good, I don't think, anyway. So it's quite possible they moved the waygate from Camelin outside of Camelin, just outside the city, or somewhere else, for that matter, to go travel to Shinar, just so they have something a little bit different there. I don't know. It's one or the other, but it's been pretty much guaranteed that this is a waygate. And I'm hoping maybe one of the Wheel in Time and Prime reveals Want Wednesday, so the next couple months we'll see the waygate in its full glory with CG and everything. I'd really like that. So Rafe, if you're watching, or Wheel of Time and Prime, or anyone else in production, yeah, we kind of want to see a waygate. I think that'd be really cool. All right, let's get on to our next set of set pictures for you. All right, so we have White Cloaks and Wolves. That's our next set of set pictures. I keep saying set of set pictures. That's terrible. Please tell me how terrible that is in the comments down below. That just sounds horrible. Anyway, so we have here, we have some pictures of the wolves. Now, these wolves had some very cute names, and they were trained. They're not real wolves, they're wolf dogs. They were trained by a kennel in the Czech Republic, and there was a whole bunch of articles about them. They did request at one point or another that some of the pictures be taken down, so I didn't show all the pictures here, and that was to WattSeries.com, because, well, again, WattSeries.com broke these pictures and the fact that they were on set. Now, we also have some pictures of White Cloaks with their faces all Nargified. Now, Narg did release these pictures as a leak, and we got to see the White Cloaks in all their glorious splendor with their really cool costumes, and I was very impressed with the costume in this. And now this appears to be a picture taken on a soundstage. They're in front of a tent. It's really, really neat. I really liked this picture. I really like seeing it, and again, Narg did leak this one last year, I think in the summer sometime last year. Correct me if I'm wrong on the time frame, I don't really remember. And then we have some stills. Now these stills are from a video. This was a set video taken on set by someone of a wolf attacking a White Cloak. Now, the video got taken down a bunch of different places and stuff, but you can still find it on Reddit, you can still find it on Instagram, you can still find it on Twitter, you can still find it, just Google it, you'll find it. I didn't show the video itself in my video when it came out, just because Amazon didn't really like the video being out there, so I just showed a couple stills and talked about it. But these are some stills from that video, showing the wolf attacking the White Cloak, which is really, really very neat, and that really only happens once in the Eye of the World, and that is when Perrin and Egwene were in the Steading, and, they got attacked, or they met, rather, the White Cloaks and got captured, so there's that. And then there's a couple more pictures at the end here of the wolves, and basically just showing that they're filming with the wolves themselves, which was really neat and really cool to see. I, for one, am very excited to see how Perrin interacts with the wolves on screen. How is he going to talk to them? Is it just going to be like an internal monologue? Will it show pictures? Well, I don't know. I think it's going to be neat, and I'm very excited to see how they portray that. So, that's another Walt Wednesday. I really like to see wolf speak. You know, how do the wolf brothers and sisters talk to one another in the wolves? I want to see that. I mean, I want to see everything, really, but that would be really neat to see, too. All right, let's get on to the next set of set pictures for you. All right, so what's Wheel of Time without some really big names? Now, we did get a chance this year to see a couple of people behind the scenes. Now, these were not official pictures, but, you know, they get leaked, and of course I'm going to look at them. Of course, a lot of people are going to look at them. So I'm forewarning you right now that these pictures are going to show characters in costume on set, and it may ruin some things for you. All right, so first up we have Moraine. Now, this was a picture that got posted on Instagram of Moraine and one of her friends, and it actually shows her in costume with her blue dress. Now, the picture was a bit bigger than this, but I had to crop out the person that was with her, as well as some of the background to, you know, make it a little bit more palatable for YouTube, but the original picture is out there in the net. You can see it, and we do get to see her in costume wearing her signature blue dress, and it is pretty cool. So Rosamund Pike here as Moraine, very neat. Now, the next picture we have here was a leaked set picture from what some of us believe to be a soundstage, but we're not entirely sure. Now, this depicts Rand and Matt. Now, I said originally in a video, a dog's age ago, a very long time ago, that this could be the episode where they're in Four Kings, just after Rand used the power for the first time. Now, this could be any other things. A lot of people theorize that it's Taren Ferry. A lot of other people have said that it's different places along the road or Shadar Logoth. I don't know. We don't really know the context behind this picture, but we do get to see Rand and Matt, so Yosha Strowski as well as Barney Harris in costume on set, which is really neat. Now, it's not exactly an HD awesome picture. It's pretty grainy, but it is fairly cool. Now, the next picture we have here is, and this is the last one we have of main cast, is of Nynaeve. That's Zoe Robbins, and Perrin, that's Marcus. Now, these two here, you can't really see them really good up close, but you do get a chance to see that signature Nynaeve braid, which is very, very cool. And you also get to see really how big Marcus is. He really does embody Perrin in his size and presence on screen. So these are the big cast pictures that we have. Now, we're kind of ending on this note because they are really, really cool. They're really big pictures. And we're all hoping, and like hoping against hope, that soon, maybe on the next Watt Wednesday, Wheel of Time on Prime will give us, you know, some HD pictures of one or two of the cast in costume. Now, we've seen some teasers recently. We've seen an audio teaser with Egwene and Perrin. We've seen another teaser with Rand's sword and then Tom's guitar. Now, they said they're going to continue this monthly, that we're going to get something at least every so often from them. I'm kind of hoping we get to see some people in costume, if not some more cast soon. All right. Well, with all that out of the way, I just do want to remind you one more time about that contest. This contest is running probably for the next 3 weeks or so, and just all you have to do is be subscribed, like my videos, leave a comment, and I'll go through all the comments after this randomly at the end of the 3 weeks, and I will pick a winner, and you get to choose either a What Up mug or to be in a video with me with a topic of your choice. Wheel of Time related, of course. You know, we're not going to talk about plants or dogs or cats or anything like that. Again, it's a Wheel of Time channel. So as long as it's Wheel of Time related and fairly PG, we'll talk about it. All right. With all that out of the way, thank you so much for sticking with me here to the very end, and here's to many more.